people say, well, you have to repent of your sins. You have to, you know, you have to believe and repent, believe and repent. And they'll say, these two things go together. You can't tie them apart. You can't do it, you know, believe and repent. But see, the problem is what they say, and this could go an entire sermon of its own. But the vast majority of people, when they say you have to repent, they just add repent of your sins, or they automatically think that that's what it means. You have to repent of your sins. You have to turn from your sins. You have to repent of your sins. Let me tell you, the word repent all by itself does not mean turn from your sins. Not at all. The easiest way, the easiest definition I could tell you what the word repent means, just rethink. The word pent is the root word for thinking. You know, I believe it comes from Latin, but regardless, if you know any Spanish, you know pensar means to think. It's the same, again, the same root word where the word comes from. Repent just means you're rethinking something. You're changing your mind. That's what the word repent means. If it had anything, if it inherently was talking about sin, like turning from your sins, well, then that would make God a sinner, because God repents in the Old Testament. You can see God repenting. It says, even in Jonah chapter 3, verse number 10, the Bible says, and God saw their works, that they turned from their evil way, and God repented of the evil they thought to do unto them. So God repented. God was going to destroy Nineveh, but he changed his mind when he saw their works. That's what the Bible says. He's Jonah 3:10. Write that down if you don't ever use that. When you come across someone who says, no, you have to repent of your sins, go to Jonah 3:10. It has all that you need. It's very clear and very concise to prove that person does not have to turn from their sins in order to be saved. Because one, it shows that God repents, so you immediately just destroy their definition of the word repent. So, was God a sinner? Did God have to repent of any sin? No, he doesn't. Because that's an important point to get across, because people just hear the word repent and they just automatically in their mind are going to add of your sin, of your sin, of your sin. It's not of your sin in every case. You can't understand the Bible with that definition of repent. You're going to be all screwed up. So one, it shows that the definition is different, but two, it shows then and defines that if you're turning from your evil way or turning from your sin, it's works. So the Bible says God saw their works, that they turned from their evil way. Turning from your wicked way. So I'll say, well, is repenting of your sin the same as turning from your wicked way? Yeah, it is. And the Bible defines that as works. Why? See, people use this phrase, oh, you're turning from your sin to the Savior. But that doesn't even make any sense. Because if you're turning from your sins, and look, we all ought to turn from our sins. I believe in this. I believe in turning from your sins, but not in order to be saved. If you turn from your sins, what's going to happen as a result is you are going to be obeying God's law. Because what is it that's making you sin? It's God's, you know, it's your lack of obedience to God's law. That's what's making you a sinner. You're not obeying God's law, therefore you're sinning. So when you turn from not obeying God's law, you're going to turn to obeying God's law. That's how you turn from your sins. So if you have to turn from your sins to be saved, then what you're saying is you have to obey God's law in order to be saved. It's the works of the law, which we already showed, are not a requirement for our salvation.